फ्रेंड्स, लेट्स कम टू नेक्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 6, एंड दैट इज इंडेक्स नंबर्स. नाउ दिस इज मोर ऑफ नंबरिंग, दिस इज मोर ऑफ न्यूमेरिकल्स. न्यूमेरिकल सम्स दे मे आस्क, जस्ट हैव अ लुक क्विकली, वी विल रिवाइज. सो बेसिकली दे इंडेक्स नंबर्स आर डिवाइसेस फॉर मेजरिंग डिफरेंसेस इन द मैग्नीट्यूड और ग्रुप ऑफ वेरिएबल्स. सो इंडेक्स नंबर हेल्प्स यू टू कैलकुलेट GDP, it helps you to calculate inflation, industrial production, changes taking place in stock market, all those things. Basically, they are statistical device, numbers will be used. They measure the net change in one or more related variables over a period of time, which means comparison can be done between the current year, previous to previous year. They are nothing but specialized averages, and they can be expressed in terms of percentage. Year for which index number is prepared is the current year, and year from which index number in which changes are measured is base year, and base year is considered as 100, where we assume 100 as a base year. They are referred as barometer of economic activity. So changes in GDP, national income, inflation, consumption, total savings, total investment, all these expressed in number terms. Previously, what was the total investment? Now it is how much? Last year, same period, what was the stock market? Today, what stock market is doing? All these comparisons, all these numerical calculations can be done through index numbers. So total 4 types: price index, quantity index, value index, and you have composite index. So price, quantity, value, and composite. Significance, that is importance. It helps in framing suitable policies, very much helpful during budget, studies trends and tendencies, okay, where economy is going, whether we are coming down, whether economy is moving up, it is coming down, whether it is at peak, whether it is at the bottom point, all these trends we will come to know. Forecasting about future economic activity, very important. Index number will compare past data with current. So we will be comparing the previous year with the current year, which will help us to understand what is going to come in future. Rough estimation. Forecasting is never accurate. Forecasting is nothing but predicting or anticipating changes which are going to take place in future. Also helpful in measurement of inflation, WPI, CPI, wholesale price index, consumer price index, useful to present financial data in real terms. So that is your national income, GDP, personal income, profits of the companies, all those things. Next, methods for constructing index number: unweighted, weighted. In that unweighted, you have simple aggregative, simple average, or price relative, and in weighted, you have weighted aggregate, weighted average, price relative. Simple price index indicates the change in price of a single item from the base year. PN upon PO into 100. Single quantity index indicates change in quantity of a single item from a base year. Your price is changing, your quantity is changing. QN upon QO into 100. Next, you have Lasprey's and Pasche's method. Just remember the formula: P01 is equals to summation P1 QO upon summation PO QO into 100. Learn this. Numerical sums they may ask, you have to solve, substitute the formula, calculate, you get the answer. Pasche's, he's a German economist, statistician, P01 is equals to summation P1 QO upon summation PO QO into 100. So this was Pasche's. Okay. Now coming to problems of index number. What are the problems associated with index number? Can I say there could be partiality or bias in the data? Data may not be proper, accurate, or it could be incomplete. So the ultimate answer or ultimate the solution for index number may not be true. Based on samples, each and every variable is not considered. Each and every unit is not considered. Sampling has been done. Okay, if there are 100 units, roughly 40-50 variables or units are taken into consideration. Sampling may not give you accurate answer. Misuse of index number. Like say example, in 2019's profit was 100 crore. 2018 profit was, say example, 50 crore, and in 2020, so while calculating, it was, I would say, say example, misuse of index number, how index number can be misused? See, current year company's profit was 50 crore, previous year it was 40 crore, so can I say compared to previous year there is 10 crore more profit? But in 2018, it was 80 crore. Now, can I say while calculating profits for 2020, 2019 should be considered as a base year? But if you consider 19 as a base year, then it shows 10 crore more profit, more tax you are supposed to pay. But company year manipulates. They consider 2018 as a base year. And what they will show? Previous year my profits were 80 crore, this year it is only 50 crore. Profits have gone down. This is manipulation so that they pay less taxes. Defect in the formula. Formula is not 100% accurate because it is just an average, just a mean. Then changes in the economy, nothing remains constant, everything keeps on changing. So there is no... nothing called as static, everything is dynamic, keeps on changing. Arbitrary, arbitrary means randomly, the data collection is done randomly, there is no proper method to collect data. So arbitrary changes taking place, scope is limited, may not be used for all purpose, and qualitative analysis, it should be more of quantitative, not qualitative. So students, these were the main things in this chapter. It was just a quick revision, what all points, what all things you need to study. So index number is easy. So next video we will discuss chapter number 7, that is national income. Thank you.